بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Welcome in Islam A to Z, section of Tazkiyatun Nafs, the purification of the soul in order to increase the love of Allah Azza wa Jal in your heart. I remember last time we spoke about one of the means that helps the person to increase the love of Allah Azza wa Jal in his heart, which is the favors that Allah granted the person, the ni'am. And we explained the different types of ni'am or favors. And tonight, another means, very effective, very helpful in terms of increasing the love of Allah Azza wa Jal in your heart. وهي الخلوة بالله في ثلث الليل الأخير وقيام الليل. To be alone with Allah Azza wa Jal at the last third part of the night and practice قيام الليل. So our topic tonight is about the importance of قيام الليل in terms of increasing the belief, increasing the love of Allah Azza wa Jal in your heart. And I think some of us or many of us, when you mention to him, do قيام الليل, he will think that it's something hard. Because when you hear قيام الليل, that you have to stay 6 hours standing and reading 10 juz and praying. No, this is not the case. قيام الليل, أخي الحبيب, عبادة. عبادة may be when you are in your bed saying Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, this قيام الليل does not necessary to pray, because the word of قيام الليل means standing in the night, either doing azkar or reading Quran or making dua to Allah Azza wa Jal or pray. And it does not necessary to pray with the long surahs, and it does not necessary to pray 11 rak'ah, 13 rak'ah, minimum 2 rak'ah. And the best timing of قيام الليل is the last third part of the night. طيب, listen to this hadith. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ينزل ربنا تبارك وتعالى كل ليلة إلى السماء الدنيا حين يبقى ثلث الليل الآخر فيقول من يدعوني فأستجيب له ومن يسألني فأعطيه ومن يستغفرني فأغفر له. This hadith is related to Aqidah, although it is mentioning about the importance of قيام الليل at the last third part of night. But I will explain what it is. Aqidah. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said that Allah Azza wa Jal تبارك وتعالى descends every night to the lowest heaven when one third of the later part of the night lifted. And he says, who supplicates me so that I may answer him? Who asks me so that I may give to him? who asks me forgiveness, so I forgive him until the dawn time. طيب, we as a Muslim, since the hadith is confirmed is a sahih, you have to accept it. So the sending of Allah Azza wa Jal, this kind of the attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal. And when you come to attribute of Allah Azza wa Jal, don't use your mind. Don't ask how. You have to affirm to Allah Azza wa Jal what He affirmed to Himself of the names and attributes mentioned in the Quran and Sahih, Sunnah, Ahad or Mutawatir. Without, you affirm the wording of the attributes, the meaning of the attributes. When you come to how or the mechanism, don't ask how. Your mind will not understand, are not able to understand how. And then you remember is nothing similar like him and is all hearing and all seeing. ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. So last third part of night. If you have 12 hours between Maghrib and Fajr, like we have now normally, so if you divide it into three sections, so for example, if Maghrib around 6, from 6 to 10 is the first third. From 10 to 2, the second third, and the best timing from 2 to the Fajr time. This is the time where the dua will be accepted. Allah says in this time, anyone asks something and he will answer. Anyone supplicate to me and will answer. Anyone ask forgiveness and I forgive him. This is the timing of the acceptance of the dua. The last third part of the night. So don't miss this part, especially now the Fajr is not early enough. But if you, before you wake up for the Fajr, maybe 10 minutes earlier, and this 10 minutes, spend this 10 minutes in dua or pray to rak'ah of Qiyamul Layli. So this is very important that you practice al-khulwa, to be alone with your Lord, with your Creator in this last part, third of the night. وقيل لأحد العباد ما هي أشد ساعة عليك؟ قال أذان الفجر. قال أو قيل له لما؟ قال لأنه يقطع مناجاة الحبيب. One of the عباد, the worshippers, that he practiced the ibadah a lot, has been asked, what is the hardest time on the day on you? Then he said, the time of Adhan al-Fajri. Why? This is the end of the best timing of Munajat, of having conversation with your Lord on the time that Allah accepted the dua. So this is the meaning that he was the hardest time when the Fajr time. And remember that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Mu'az in Jabal an advice, and a long advice, and one of his advice, أَلَا أَدُلُّكَ عَلَىٰ أَبْوَابِ الْخَيْرِ. Shall I tell you about the gate of good? الصوم جنة. Fasting is a protection. والصدقة تطفئ الخطيئة. And صدقة remove or raise the sins. كما يطفئ الماء النار, like the water extinguish the fire. وصلاة الرجل في جوف الليل ثم قال تلا تتجافى جنوبهم عن المضاجع حتى بلغ يعملون. طيب, he explained to Mu'az that the صدقة, the fasting and praying in the deep time of the night, when everyone is sleeping, everyone on his bed, and you wake up and you pray to Allah Azza wa Jal. And the verse تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجَ, their side leave their beds on the night because of that prayer. So Salatul Layli is a very important means for getting the love of Allah Azza wa Jal. Also, we need to know how can we do Qiyamul Layli. Is it necessary, as I said, it could be reading Quran, could be tasbih, could be dua, could be salah. But most of the people do the salah. So what is the ruling of night prayer, Qiyamul Layl? Any prayer in the part of the night is called Qiyamul prayer or night prayer. For example, witr salah, it is one of the Qiyamul Layl. If you pray with, this is one of the Qiyamul Layl. وعن عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنه عنهما أنه قال, he said that I spend one night in the house of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and my auntie Maymuna, his wife of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, Maymuna, the auntie of Abdullah ibn Abbas. And then Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم gets up in the night and he prayed two plus two. How many rak'ah now? 12. Six? Yeah, two. And then he make witr. So this is the way that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed the Qiyamul Layli. He prayed mathna mathna, two two, even even. And then he end his salah with the witr. وفي حديث أيضا صلاة الليل مثنى مثنى فإن خشيت الصبح فأوتر, means the night prayer is an even even, and if you afraid the time of the fajr, then make witr salah. This is the way that Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم explained to the ummah to pray. So you can start Qiyamul Layl after Isha. If you worried that you may not get in the up in the night, pray Qiyamul Layl after Isha, no problem. But if you more likely you wake up, in this case you can delay Qiyamul Layl just to the last third of the night. But if you test yourself, okay, I will sleep and wake up in the night, but you time by time you didn't get up, in this case pray after Isha because you will still get reward. طيب, what is the advantages of Qiyamul Layl? عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال أفضل الصيام بعد رمضان شهر الله المحرم وأفضل الصلاة بعد المكتوبة صلاة الليل. So Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said that the best fasting after Ramadan is the fasting in the month of Al-Muharram, شهر الله المحرم. We just finished last month. And then he said وأفضل الصلاة, the best صلاة is a night prayer, صلاة الليل. So as you can see, it came after the compulsory salah. So Salatul Layli is the second after the compulsory salah. طيب. Also, Qiyamul Layli and Salatul Layli, the night prayer, erase the sayyi'at. We just mentioned Hadith Mu'adh that Salatul Rajuli, the prayer of the man, في جوف الليل, in the deep time of night, ماذا تفعل? From the goodness, from the أبواب الخير, from the gate of the خير, bring the goodness to yourself. And also قيام الليل, if you pray قيام الليل, it will expel headliness أن غفلة في الوحارت and also it reason for acceptance of dua. I remember I mentioned this hadith before, but just reminding you about this hadith. من تعارى من الليل فقال لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له الحمد لله سبحان الله لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله ثم دعا الله استجيب له وإذا توضأ وصلى قبلت صلاته. If the person gets up in the night and then he said لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. Do you know the أذكار after salah? This is the end of the أذكار. And then you say الحمد لله like أذكار الصلاة. سبحان الله different sequence. So الحمد لله سبحان الله لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. And then you do the dua, Allah will accept the dua. This is in the late night. This hadith sahih in Bukhari, you have to believe it and you practice this hadith. Instead of looking your messages or googling on the social media on the night, if you get up in the night, say لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير الحمد لله سبحان الله لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله and do the dua. Allah will accept this dua for sure. You have to believe that. Prophet said that, you have to believe it. And then if you pray, if you make a wudu and pray, the salah will be accepted. It's something not easy to have an accepted salah, because every one of us pray, but we don't know this salah will be accepted or not. So when you ask the sheikh about something you did in the salah, don't ask him, does my salah accepted? Don't ask this question. But it is valid or invalid, sahih, correct or incorrect. But even you do the arkan and the wajibat and the shurut, the sunan, the hayat in salah, but we don't know it is well accepted or not. But this hadith give you the guarantee that it will be accepted. And Abdullah ibn Umar قال, if I know that Allah accepts from me one sajda, that's enough for me. I will rely on that. One sajda accepted could be reason for you to enter the Jannah. So don't miss this time in the night and say this dua and pray two rak'ah if you can. These two rak'ah will be accepted. طيب, one more advantage of qiyam al-layli or the night prayer in Ramadan especially. As you know, in Ramadan we have Taraweeh. And Taraweeh, it is special night prayer in Ramadan after Isha. Hadith Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, on the time of Ramadan, Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam start fasting of Ramadan and he didn't pray any prayer during the first 20 nights of Ramadan. And when the last 10 nights started, he didn't pray as well. He started praying when 7 nights left, which is the 23rd night. And then he prayed up to the 3rd of the night. And then he finished. Then the next night he didn't pray. And then the follow after that, he, which is the 25th, he prayed with the Sahaba until the half of the night. So the first night was up to the third of the night, and then the second night, which is 25th, up to the half. And then the Sahaba enjoyed the Salah, and they want to stay more. And then they asked the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, shall you extend the Salah more than that? And then he said to them, if the man prayed with his Imam until he finished his Salah, the rest of the night will be counted from him as a Qiyamul Layl. Yani if you stay with your Imam in Taraweeh until he finished all the Salah, even you didn't pray after that, so the rest of the night will be counted for you as a Qiyamul Layl, a night prayer. This is also a very good example about the importance. And some people in Ramadan especially, they so rash and then pray maybe 4 rak'at and leave, 8 rak'at and leave. And if the Imam praying 20, they just eight and leave. But if you stay to the end until he finish, the rest of the night will be counted for you as a night prayer. So far, one of the importance of night prayer, if you memorize the Quran. And by the way, memorizing Quran is not restricted to the Huffaz only or to the scholar. Everyone has to memorize as much as he can from Quran. Don't leave yourself without memorization. Because memorizing Quran is a great knowledge, you have to learn it. And night prayer, one of the means that help you to revise your memorization. Everyone check his amount of memorization. For example, if you memorize Juz'a Amma, during the night prayer, every night he take maybe a few surahs from Juz'a Amma until he finishes and keep going. This will be strong by time. If you know more than 2 juz or 3, just the same. Distribute it over the week so you will fix your memorization. This is a very important point, especially if you want to make your hifz and Quran strong. Last things to let you go, but please drink and eat this. Pass it to the others. عن عبد الله بن سلام رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول يا أيها الناس أفشوا السلام وأطعموا الطعام. Give food, the food is here. وأطعموا الطعام وصلوا والناس نيام تدخلوا الجنة بسلام. طيب wait for Daniel until he comes. جزاك الله خيرا brother حبيبي. Just this hadith came on time. أطعموا الطعام means feed, yeah. And the food is here. طيب عبد الله بن سلام said that I hear Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, O people, extend the greeting or exchange the greeting. If you enter a place, say Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Or at least Assalamu alaikum for the Muslim. For non-Muslim, you can say their normal greeting or say Assalamu ala man ittaba al-huda. Peace be upon who follow the guidance. So afshu salam means spreading the greeting, the salam. وَأَطْعِمُوا الطَّعَامِ and give the food or invite the people for food or feed the people. وَصِلُوا الْأَرْحَامِ and connect your relative. وَصَلُّوا وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامِ and pray while the people are sleeping. In the late night, everyone is sleeping and you get up in the night and you pray. This is what will happen for these people, the one who spread the salam and feed the ta'am and connect the arham and pray while the people niyam are sleeping. What happened for those people? تدخل الجنة بسلام. You will enter the Jannah peace with peace. خلاص. Again, أفشوا السلام. صلوا الأرحام وأطعموا الطعام وصلوا والناس نيام تدخل الجنة بسلام. The shahid here or the point here that قيام الليل is the reason for you to enter the Jannah. هلم إلى العمل. Let us practice that after this lesson, either here or in your home, before you go sleep. If you are, want to do two rak'ah only, قل هو الله أحد قل أضرب بالفلاح. خلاص. Enough. Start at that. And the best عمل is a continued عمل even little. Allah love the عمل even it is little but continuous. Don't leave this chance. قيام الليل شرف, is an honor for the mu'min. By any way, two rak'ah, four rak'ah, at least two rak'ah, doesn't necessary to be a long surah, whatever you have, but keep it consistent every night and don't leave it, inshallah. Inshallah, ready? Barakallahu feekum, inshallah. Jazakum Allah khayran. See you tomorrow after Isha for Hadith al-Bukhari, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum. Yes.
So, feeding is for anyone or just poor?
No, not anyone. Anyone. The general. Because you will get reward for feeding the people to show the love between each other. You invite the people for walima if you married, for aqiqa if you have children. This is also, you'll be rewarded for that. So, this is any feeding, that is said to be poor. If you have a guest, you honor him by giving him food. You'll be rewarded as well. بارك الله فيك. شكرا شكرا حبيبي. أحسن الله عليك. شكرا. تسلم يدك يا حبيبي. بارك الله فيك. كلام كلام.
بارك الله فيك.
أحسن الله عليك.
So last this what you said, all things should be done or people who does one of these.
Very good question. والله. We dealing with the merciful Lord. So our Lord is a merciful. So inshallah anyone do one of these four, inshallah we enter the Jannah. So يعني خليه على الله. Leave it to Allah. inshallah. Last any question? Barakallahu feekum. Turn off this.